Mastitis is the inflammation of the mammary gland. It exists probably ever since dairy cows exist. Annual losses worldwide due to mastitis are 30 plus billion euro. Mastitis remains to be a challenge for dairy farms because it's an extremely complex disease. The pathogens causing mastitis are constantly evolving. The industry, they need to develop different preventive measures or different treatment strategies for individual pathogens. Mastitis and udder health are always hot topics at conferences and in various technical magazines, and people are constantly discussing new ideas and new insights in terms of what could be improved. One of these ideas was that on top of looking at total somatic cell count, we also look at the actual composition of the cells in milk, meaning we do cell differentiation, differentiation of immune cells. Differential somatic cell count adds more information about the actual udder health status of dairy cow by telling us what kind of immune cells predominate in the milk. We are able to further define in what stage of mastitis a cow actually is. When we talk about cells in milk, we refer to different types of cells, those being lymphocytes, polymorphonuclear neutrophils, and macrophages. When a cow is healthy, the somatic cell count would be low, for example, at 30 or 50,000 cells per milliliter, and the cells in this stage consist mainly of macrophages. The macrophages do have surveillance functions, meaning they are checking for abnormalities. As soon as it comes to an infection by bacteria, the macrophages would recognize that and start recruiting cells from the bloodstream, which eventually results in an increase in total somatic cell count. At the same time, the composition of the cells changes from mainly macrophages to predominantly polymorphonuclear neutrophils. The function of the neutrophils is to simply kill the bacteria. Once the neutrophils succeeded in doing so, the somatic cell count will start to decrease and macrophages will take over again. The third population, the lymphocytes, they do only play a minor role in this whole process. So they would occur with consistently low proportions. In the past, cell differentiation was described as a purely scientific method, very tedious method because the cells had to be isolated from milk samples and then investigated under a microscope. In 2017, FOSS launched the FOSS-O-Matic 7DC instrument with the capability of doing somatic cell count and differential somatic cell count simultaneously, and that at a speed of up to 600 samples per hour. So now the industry has a possibility to generate differential somatic cell count information under practical conditions at low cost. Today, somatic cell count is the key parameter for mastitis management in the industry. And we are working, for example, with a threshold of 200,000 cells in order to differentiate between cows that are normal or healthy and those that are likely to be infected. In the future, we can add a second dimension to this differentiation, meaning the differential somatic cell count, and then use a specific threshold there. We don't have the exact threshold determined today, but that threshold will help us to differentiate between cows that have an active immune response versus those that have an inactive immune response, based on predominance of PMNs or macrophages. We are absolutely convinced that differential somatic cell count is going to be a great and very valuable tool in the future to further improve udder health management and milk quality in general.